Hi, my name is Joesph Pepe Danza. Thank you for bringing me home with you. We are going to do a djembe lesson. And the djembe is a drum from West Africa, as you probably know. However, I come from a country called Uruguay, or as you might say, Uruguay. In Uruguay, what we have is the Afro-Latin tradition. Now, the Afro-Latin tradition is quite different from the African tradition. The Afro-Latin tradition happens with all the slaves coming to South America in different mixtures from different nations. They basically recreate their culture and create very local phenomena that are strictly South American. They don't exist as such in Africa, and yet it's purely African culture. So the culture in Uruguay is called candombe. That's our national rhythm. You have samba and all kinds of rhythms in Brazil. You have rumba and all kinds of other rhythms in Cuba. They're very specific with their specific instruments. They're very different from each other and from anything that happens in Africa. Now, of course, the djembe is a very popular drum nowadays. Everybody is playing a djembe. There was a great teacher that came to North America in the 50s, Baba Olatunji. He basically brought African drumming to North America, a great man. And he predicted that in 10 years, everybody would have a djembe in their household. We may be close to that. And from hippies carrying their djembes in their bags to older people wanting to get into drumming and find their inner rhythm, there's a lot of Western people playing the djembe now. Beautiful thing in terms of we're all sharing one rhythm, and also kind of dangerous in terms of diluting a very incredible culture. So there's teachers out there, such as Mama Diketa, that are very strict about keeping the tradition pure. And then there's people like me who are adapting the djembe to their own Afro traditions. I think these trends do not fight each other. I think they can work together very beautifully. I think they're both very important. The trend that makes sure the tradition is kept pure, and the trend that makes the tradition evolve to the next stage. So sometimes people fight with each other about these things. I think they're both very important. Now, I apply my Afro-Latin traditions to the djembe. But we're going to talk first about technique and basic principles that apply to anything you want to play. However, I do encourage you very much, if you're going to play a djembe or any instrument for that matter, that you really understand where it comes from, the tradition, that you understand what the traditional rhythms are and what they're used for, and that you have a general education and respect for the tradition of the drum. And then once you understand that, and once you have the basic knowledge of the technique, then you can take it and make it your own and play your own music. But I think the foundation is really important to understand the original tradition of the instrument. Principles of the drum. Let's see. The first thing about drumming is, you know, forget about the word beat the drum. I have a problem with that. And beating the drum, basically energetically, is a subtle thing, but energetically you're going into the drum. And so what you want to think about always is going away from the drum. So imagine bringing the sound gently from the drum rather than beating it into the drum. So if I play a stroke, let's say I play the bass stroke on the drum and I beat my drum, my energy is going to go into the drum. And that hurt my hand. It's not a pleasant sound. Instead, what I want to do is bring the sound out. So imagine an out arrow. And that's a sweet sound. It's not hurting my hand. The volume in the hand comes really from your intention and your clarity of what you want to say. If you're clear about what you want to say and you develop your technique, you can have as much volume as you need without any effort. And that's what you're looking for. You're looking for effortlessness. It's a very Taoist thing. The less you do, the more you will get. If you're engaging a lot of muscles and a lot of willpower, you're going to sound tense and you're going to sound loud and unpleasant. What you want to do is always be very, very relaxed and have a very clear idea of what you want to say. Just like I'm moving my mouth and my tongue to speak the language of English, the language of the drum is in the hands. And that's where you have to be very clear, just like I'm clear about what I want to tell you, and my mouth is moving according to the clarity of my thought. Same with the drum. So that's why some master drummers suffer when they see amateurs playing in drum circles, because to our ears, it's like a bunch of babbling. You have to be clear what you want to say. Not unlike the piano, you know, if you start banging on the white keys of the piano, you're probably going to be in some key, C major probably, and you can't go wrong, but you're still banging keys. It's debatable whether that's music. Whether if you know what you want to say and you pick Twinkle Little Star slowly and gently, well, there you have music. So the intention has to come first, the clarity, and that's where learning traditional rhythms is really important, because that clarifies the process between learning something, internalizing something, and then externalizing it in your drum. The other aspect that for me is very important, and this is a personal thing, is what you're carrying inside as a human being. The whole notion of releasing your anger into the drum is challenging for me. I think I see the drum as an amplifier of where you're at, and you're basically broadcasting your state of being through the drum. So I much prefer to broadcast peace and harmony through my drum than anger. And so it's very, very important to me to come to a state of inner harmony and inner knowledge and clarity of intention in this regard, and then broadcast it through my drum. So sometimes I take my time to really check into where I'm at before drumming. One of the most important things, the most important thing is breathing. I encourage you to explore the fact that in general, as human beings, we've lost the capacity for full breathing, just as we lost the capacity for full use of our brains. And I encourage you to explore deep breathing and yoga breathing and come back to a more natural state of breathing. And once in a while you're doing your practice of djembe, forget a little bit about the technique and about the rhythms and anything else except the act of breathing while drumming, and really condition yourself to breathe fully while you drum. And of course, when it comes to breathing, posture is very important, right? So, you know, if you're here, you're not gonna breathe fully and you're not gonna drum very well. So you want to have a very nice, relaxed, open posture. Again, exercise and yoga. Really, if you dedicate yourself to the drum will naturally take you into a more holistic way of carrying yourself and your own relationship to your body. I've been drumming for 30 years, and slowly I've had to adapt my diet and my daily exercise, and because otherwise, you know, it's a very physical thing, and you need the staying power, and that affects the way you live. So I am blessed with having my drum as my teacher, really, because it has impacted my life in profound ways, and I hope it does the same for you.